Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen, to Lawrenceville, Georgia, as Georgia Gwinnett splits the doubleheader with Coastal Georgia here today. We're joined now by head softball coach Kat Ihlenburg. Coach, coming into this day, it's been a lot of changes with this team. Wanted to play four doubleheaders in a matter of a week. After it's all said and done, what's your evaluation of the Grizzlies' performance on the whole week?
You know, we're a great club. I think we have a lot of positives that we take away, even in the midst of a loss that looks frustrating, but we have a really good team and the chemistry's there, the energy's there. So we've seen a lot of good things in the start of our season out of the month of February.
What does it mean for the Grizzlies to get out to a good start in game number one today, and then Coastal battles back, and now you got a late inning battle that the Grizzlies pull out a win?
You know, it was just another example of resilience. This team just keeps proving to themselves that they're capable of really backing each other up, and we've talked about that from 1 to 23. We've got to have each other's backs. And so Lex kind of got a little unglued, if you will, you know, just didn't hit the strike zone as hard as she could. And call on Lainey Trent. We know that she's going to be a role player for us, and your role is to come in when you're called on, and she does. And then even when she got the opportunity to hit, that's what we have told her time and time again through our months of practice, that that's what you're going to do. And here you see it unfold today. It was pretty awesome.
Yeah, you took the answer to my next question here, which is we've relied on Gracie Hogg and Alexa Good inside the center circle, but we see both Lainey Trent and Piper Wagner. What does this mean inside the center circle for this pitching staff?
We're team-oriented this year, Matt. You know, you've seen different players come in different situations throughout the 10 games we've gotten to play in February. And what's most important is that when those players come in, that they feel the same confidence of their team being behind them. And Lainey had some great plays behind her with our defense, and it was a little different in game two for Piper. But, you know, those are things you learn from and you do better next time.
Grizzlies win game number one by a score of 8-6. Then in game number two, you find yourself behind 8-1 going into the sixth. Then the rally starts with two runs in the sixth. Even into the seventh, you had a lot of base runners, a lot of base hits. Did the Truett game cross your mind at all there going into the last inning?
The Truett game crossed my mind as soon as we were down 4-1. And so that's how our program operates right now is, you know, we're really process-oriented. I've said that word 10 times now. but we're trying to think about our team and the quality that we want to produce and what we want to see and line drive focus. And you saw that come out in the sixth and seventh. But, you know, unfortunately, we put ourselves in a bit of a bigger bind than we had previously.
Big week for the Grizzlies. Probably it's the most games that they played. It's been the most endurance, the most taxing on their body. What's next here? A couple days off. I know you guys are going to hit the road here soon.
Yeah, we're looking forward to some road trips. Obviously, we're going to take tomorrow off. It's going to rain, which is great. The field probably needs a little bit. You know, there were some rocks that were hit out on the field today to give some pretty hops. But we need, you know, just a day to refocus, you know, kind of flush this one. Tuesday, Wednesday, great practice days. Thursday, try and take some from Montreat and head to Reinhardt across town on Saturday. And Reinhardt's club's doing great, so I know they're not just going to, you know, let us have one. So looking forward to those games. They're always a great club to play.
Grizzlies rally comes up just a little bit short in game number two. Coach Kat, thank you so much for your time here today.
Thanks, Matt. I always appreciate it.
That'll do it for us here in Lawrenceville, Georgia, as GGC splits the doubleheader with CCG here on the Grizzly Digital Network.